Hi, welcome back. I'm here with Joshua Bloch. Josh is a leading textbook author, Effective Java, book on concurrency in Java, a devilish book on Java puzzlers, and was one of the leaders who brought Java to us and worked on the early APIs, including the collections class and so on. What was that process like?
I was in the right place at the right time, and I have always enjoyed APIs. It's kind of been the recurring theme of my career for the past 20 years, but I used to write them for 10 or 15 people, and all of a sudden I was writing them for millions of people. It was chaotic. That's the way the internet was back in those days. Type systems should exist to serve the programmer and not vice versa. If you find yourself constantly fighting with the type system, writing a program that won't compile, and you just spend, you know, lots of time sort of jamming the thing through the compiler and it wears you out, and you don't really gain any insight in the process, then there's something wrong with the type system. And I believe that Java's wild cards have that problem. In the case of Java, you've got an existing language that was kind of designed around strong static typing. And if you try to put dynamic stuff into it, there is a little bit of an impedance mismatch. Things that are added to languages after the fact tend not to reside comfortably in the language. And when languages grow too much and stray too far from their roots, you generally end up with big messes.
Now, so you talked about reliability of algorithms. You did a blog post about a bug in a decades-old algorithm on binary search. What happened there?
That was an amazing story. So I was at Carnegie Mellon University from 1982 to 1990 or so. And when I had first arrived, I took a PhD-level algorithms course from John Bentley, who is a brilliant and funny man. I mean, he started out by asking us all, so how many of you know how to write binary search? We all raised our hands. We were hotshot computer scientists. You know, we got our bachelor's, and we felt we knew what we were doing. And he said, okay, fine. You know, take out a piece of paper and write it. You know, you got 10 minutes, then we'll talk. 10 minutes later, he said, okay, who got it right? And everybody raises their hand. He picks one person and says, put your algorithm on the board. The person does, and he tears it apart. And the point, you know, of course, the person had not gotten it right. It was broken. And the point of his lecture was that you need to use invariants in your code, and in particular, binary search. The invariants are tricky, and if you don't think of it in terms of invariants, you'll get it wrong. Language design is always going to be an aesthetic exercise. You need good taste if you're going to do it, and you are operating partially from the gut. Empiricism is one important part of what you're doing, but if something feels wrong or feels ugly, then it's probably a bad idea. There are some people who are really good at doing the aesthetic stuff and in sort of placing themselves in the shoes of the programmer and saying, yes, you know, this will feel right. Other people can't do that, but they're really good at, you know, looking at a grammar and saying, oh, you know, I'm afraid that you're going to end up with an ambiguity here, if not now, when we add these other features that we intend to add. So the point is, empiricism is great. I would even say it's necessary now, but it's not sufficient.